Joining us on the line right now, D.C. Councilmember Vincent Orange. Mr. Orange, how are you today?
I'm doing very well. How about yourself?
We're doing very well. Look, I want to talk about the Walmart matter. You are one of eight council members who voted in favor of a bill. You were very much in favor of it that would require big retailers like Walmart to pay a minimum wage of $12.50, while other retailers, the perhaps smaller retailers, would only pay $8.25. You said at the time that, you know what, the city doesn't need Walmart. Walmart needs the city. We, these retailers don't need the city. We don't need them. They need us. Since then, Walmart has said, look, if this becomes law, we're pulling out three stores. Six retailers have said that they will reconsider their growth plans. These are companies like Target, Home Depot, AutoZone, Walgreens, the Lowe's companies, Macy's have all said, we'll reconsider our growth plan in D.C. if your law becomes law. And then, there's another report out there that three major retailers have already told some folks in the district, we're yanking it out. We're not coming there. We don't like this law at all. So do you still think that D.C. Doesn't need the retailers? The retailers need them?
Well, the retailers are knocking on our door because the District of Columbia has one of the highest disposable incomes in the nation. We have 1,000 new residents coming in every month. You got to remember, we're doing quite well. We're just coming off of $800 million in surpluses over our last four fiscal years. Our CFO, Dr. Gandhi, has just predicted that we will have another $600 million in surpluses over the next four fiscal years. We have a plan to create 50,000 jobs over the next decade, so the city is doing extremely well. In fact, we're the envy of a lot of cities throughout the United States.
But and isn't there a suggestion here that a lot of these companies are not willing to come to the district or continue their growth plans in the district if you pass this bill? Doesn't that make you want to stop and reconsider the matter?
No, because you know if they come to town, we welcome them into town, but we will not allow them to pay poverty wages. You know, the reason why they're able to make so much money and do so well is because they force governments to pick up the safety costs. Safety costs being defined as, you know, providing food stamps, Medicaid costs, and things of that nature. In the District of Columbia, we want to have a policy that consists of a living wage, access to affordable housing, access to health care, and a good education, and
okay,
can begin to move forward.
Councilmember Orange, minimum wage is a poverty wage. All right, we'll remember that. I'm looking at the itemized expenditures of your last campaign. You paid Barbara Gibson a salary stipend of $40. Jamesy Davis got a salary stipend of $43. Christine Fields got a salary stipend of $20. Were you paying them a living wage? How much work did they do for only $40?
Well, gathering signatures for a campaign. That's not the issue.
Because you're asking Walmart to be held to a higher standard than you do in your own campaign.
Well, Walmart generates $470 billion in sales last year. Their net income was $17 billion. Their CEO makes $11,000 an hour.
So they should be held to a higher standard than you do with the people who work to get you elected.
They should not be able to pay poverty wages in the District of Columbia.
$40 to get signatures?
Enforce our taxpayers to take on their burden.
Let me ask you this.
We should not have to pay health care costs. We should not have to pay, you know, provide food stamps and things of that nature while someone else prospers. In the words of Franklin D. Roosevelt, he said that it's the test of our progress is not to provide abundance to those who have much. The test is to provide help to those that have very little.
Franklin D. Roosevelt also didn't want any public sector unions, but I doubt you would agree with that position. Let me ask you this. You hired a consultant firm called King & Associates, and you also hired a company called TCB Corporation to handle fundraisers for you. Do you make them pay a living wage as well?
We're not here to talk about a campaign. We're talking about the business.
But you hire these companies to work for you. Do you hold them to the same standard?
We're talking about retailers that want to come and do business in the District of Columbia.
Well, then why not raise the minimum wage across the board then? You don't seem to be interested in doing that.
I think the President of the United States has proposed wage increasing the minimum wage.
But I mean, no, if you believe that $8.25 is not enough, why not say every retailer in the District of Columbia must pay a minimum wage? Why are you singling out just the big and successful corporations and not everybody
because it's
all about protecting the little guy?
Corporations want to come into the nation's capital, and they can't come on their terms. They want to do business. They want what we have. They're here knocking on this door because this city is doing well.
Well, how are you going to feel?
And we're saying that we want our residents to do well as well.
$12.50
per hour, that's only $26,000 a year, but two people on a living wage can have the opportunity to purchase a home in the District of Columbia. At $8.25 per hour, that's $17,000 a year, two people working together, it's $34,000. You cannot buy a home in the District of Columbia.
I would think that any job is better than no job. And a lot of jobs are going to be lost if Walmart pulls out three stations.
Will you yourself take a pay cut and make $8.25?
Are you going to pay your employees more than
$8.25 an hour?
All right. No. Councilmember Orange, we had your colleague, Yvette Alexander, was on the show last week. She told us that you both went to Las Vegas to court businesses to try to woo them to come to D.C. When you were in Las Vegas, did you tell those businesses they were going to have to pay this quote-unquote living wage?
When we were in Las Vegas, we met with Costco, who said we were doing a great job, and you've seen yesterday's paper, they pay an average salary of $19 per hour, and they're doing extremely well. They're here located in the District of Columbia. It's just in terms of your philosophy. Their philosophy is they don't want turnover. This is Costco. Uh-huh. And if they pay their workers well, their workers will stay with the company, they will grow with the company, and everyone prospers together.
So my question is, when you were in Vegas talking to businesses other than Costco, did you let them know that if they come to D.C., they were going to have to pay this living wage?
They were well aware that the bill was on the table and that we would be voting on it, so yes.
You told them. All right.
Yes.
All right, Councilmember Orange, it's great to have you. We hope to have you back as this continues.
Would you at least be intellectually honest and say that this is really about being pressure being applied by the unions?
Well, I think you should be honest and just look at it this way. The policy of the District of Columbia is going to be a living wage, access to health care, access to affordable housing, and a good education.
Unless you work for the Orange campaign.
And that is the Maslow's hierarchy of needs. Give people opportunity to prosper and build.
I am sure the people that work on your campaign are excited to hear that.
Well, people that work on my campaign, the campaigns are short. I mean, this is a red herring that you're talking about. Talk about the issue.
Well,
a living wage is a living wage no matter what you're doing.
Asking you to live up to the same standards that you're holding to these large companies.
Well, if I was generating $470 billion and I had $17 billion of income, and if I was making $11,000 an hour, I would be ashamed to try to pay someone poverty wages so I can continue my abundance and my high style of living.
All right, sir. We'll have to leave it.